No one! So in your head! How can you not see? Fuck it up! Except in his Rocky King. Huh. How are they not? I wouldn't say that. Wait a minute. What? Darn it. Okay, it's really hard one. Nice move. Keep me safe. How do you come over here and fight us? Okay, look at that mine. I don't know what to say. I never charged any rifle. Okay. I'm not gonna metagame either. I didn't get radiation. into the dog's prototype. Oh my god. Private Hutt's holotape. Yeah, I'm gonna take the army helmet. Man, she was really destroyed here. The devil's you. So I think it was Private Hutt's right?
From Lynn Woods for some robot butler. What was his name? Wellington? Wellingham?
Not now, Private. Where's Connors? He's not at his post.
Sorry, sir. The lieutenant said he found some tracks. Wanted to check them out. Private Martin.
Tracks? What track? What the hell is that?
Oh, my. Connors! Where's the rest of him?
Ooh. That's a good question, though, isn't it? Now we know the answer to this. And I would say I'm glad for my cheese. Good question, Piper, good question. I think it was a surgical scalpel. I think he used for surgery, you know? Huh. Well, that's interesting. Just so this dude by. At this point. I can't figure out I missed that and cue that sound effect. That's a big hole. Okay, I was scared by the mannequin more than the body. So the gunners is who's got snuck up by something. And whatever it was big. Any guesses, guys? Any guesses about what this creature could be? I'm not sure right after that, but... Hey, let's see what you guys can guess. You guys are smart, right? I have to agree with you on that one, Piper. Alright, this is my usual choke point here. So we're gonna quick save. Where is it? Wait, what? Yeah, I am very shocked. Maybe some other wasteland just happened to share the name Skeldok Obmois. The note was not meant for him. And the note was meant for him. One of the reasons Skeldok Obmois decided to keep reading, why the heck not? There was no guarantee the word on the paper referring to him. It was only a paper mirror. A reflection made up of words on a page, besides the only way to know for sure was to keep reading to the end. But even then, having to read the page and learn his future, there was no reason to take the word seriously. At some point, he would go back outside, run the wasteland again, perhaps forget about the note altogether. Eventually, those troubles would bring him to a dugout inn in Diamond City. Of course, Skeldok Obmois wasn't there for on business. He just wanted to relax. But as he walked into the inn, a mystical glow of neon something came to the right, caught his eyes. Was bounty for a killer named Zane. Someone wanted him dead. Might as well take out this death glow arts here. Oh boy. That had a skull above it. Yes, that's good, Piper, that's good. Piper, don't go back out there! And there we go. Ah, here he is. No, he's not the one we were looking for. Crack death legs. If we take them. Okay, that's a bit gross. Why is there so many cracked ones?
A nest full of deathclaw eggs. A dozen, maybe more. Smashed to bits. Except this one. No wonder they wouldn't tell us what was in that case. If I'd known, I would have personally told the gunner bosses and that glorified liquor cabinet Wellingham to take those Diamond City caps and stuff them. Yes, we know why that Deathclaw tracked us all the way from Lynn Woods now. They stole their damn kids. Christ. Maybe if we just return the eggs. Oh, hey, Mama. You looking for this?
I get the feeling that didn't end well. Oh, there you are. I'm just returning your egg. Even Big Vicious Deathclaw with her. We should probably leave the area and not investigate those corpses. He's already dead. This is not boding well for us, says Piper. Combat knife. Zane's associates. Zane's joy, shotgun shell. Handwritten note. It will betray you too. It will. What will betray me? Okay, that's just a scar. So it's like an interesting symbol. Zane's associates. Since it fitted Gory around my own business and to material rifle, that's what we're looking for, I believe. Green Tech Genetics. That's a crossbar? Just came after him. All he had to do was put the book ahead and read the next chapter of his story. It told him everything he needed to know. He knew where the attackers were coming from and when they arrived. The mirror showed him everything, but every time he turned a page, it brought him closer to the end. Now there was no more pages left. Someone was coming for him, someone bad, and no amount of preparation would help him survive. At first, Zane refused to believe it. He tore out the page in anger and slammed on the table. When the time came, he would prove the mirror was a lie. He'd bunker down in the old concrete beaches and kill whatever air came walking through that door. But when he read that word, heard and discovered the hunters had a mirror of their own, he knew there was no escape. He was going to die tonight. And his friends would soon follow. The only matter that the kitchen could get was to kill himself before the bounty hunter got there first. Okay, so he committed. He on a life sentence, okay? So he sat down and took out the vodka. The one he'd been saving for after he got out of the common broke. He popped it open, took a sip, waved his other hand, pulled the trigger. I can't even see a gun in there. But we just killed Silas. We're gonna destroy as soon as I finish doing this place. Ooh, they put the full body in here. Let's back out to the Commonwealth. Finish up the league. Alright. Inventory, miscellaneous. There is Silas' story. Handed Silas the pages that pertained to him and told him to head out to Lexington. In the old washing machine for weeks now, Silas nodded his head, redunking into this. He didn't want anything to do with whatever voodoo was in that book. The thing that spoke to him enough just by having his name in it, but what spoke to him even more was when they found the book. Some of the pages were missing. Interesting. Yeah. I thought you were running them. Anyway, now it's again. Hey, Eddie. Because it says to do the Barnes Spur AB. The gun's away. Okay, that wasn't worth my experiment. Oh boy. Oh. Press in! Ivy knew she had lunch. And someone did. But while the hunter came need to find a killer. Something told him to stay his hand. It could have been pity for the young woman, or perhaps it was a desire to circumvent fate. Whatever the reason, Skuttock Umbus chose to do what few who before him dared to do. He rejected the story that was written in the mirror, and took his fate into his own hands. When the Lonzo Hunters came, Skuttock Umbus fought him off. In that moment, Ivy saw a chance to escape. She knew another exit, one where she wouldn't be followed. Part of her wanted to say thank you to the stranger for sparing her life, but she couldn't risk dying along with him. In the end, she left behind the pages of her mirror. Maybe that would be things enough. That was things enough. So it does change depending on which one you chose. We defied fate. You walked right into that one. We got the Pantry Anti-Material Rifle. Nice! And target damage and energy resistance. Ooh. Don't make me come in there. I got too close. I got too close. Nor a gun.
Waving that gun in my face, or it's gonna involve me.
Okay, okay, just take it easy. We'll lower our weapons, all right? Go crazy. What's going on here? It's a simple business dispute. Got it? Truth is, they're not a pile of goods that she owes me. I tried racing with her, but it looks like I gotta take what's mine by force. Wanna make some easy money? Help me out. I could use another gun. I'll talk to her. Maybe we can work this out. If things go sideways, we'll back
up. All right. Okay, Trudy, you might have a problem.
Hey there.
I saw you with that poison seller talking. Well, he ain't getting his money. Here.
And peacefully.
We get paid, and I don't even gotta shoot nobody. Good job. Here. Now, how about I show you all the pick-me-ups I have to offer?
I've got a few minutes to browse.
Now, remember, moderation.
There we go. We also probably should wait this one out. Oh yeah, sure. Where are you?
Sure, go ahead. When we first met, I admit, I had my doubts about it, but you've done nothing but impress me. It's just to the minute they needed to put the cap on the face.
Thanks. Make a difference.
To say is thanks. Anyway, I appreciate you taking the time to listen.
Anytime, Preston.
Thanks, man. We probably better get back to it.
Thanks for helping us out with Trudy. You did good. Now, let's talk business.
Gonna pass.